5?
5.
6. I need no answers, guys.
7.
Okay, cool. How about others?
100%.
100%? Awesome. Brilliant. So, okay. So, the rules of the game is it has to be interactive. If there is a question popping in your mind, ask it right then. Because what happens is, we forget otherwise. You know, at the end of the session, if we park the questions, and I like it better when there is a question, there is an interaction, then you get to see, or there are a lot of interesting stories that come out. I've seen it in my experience whenever I talk, that the more interactive the crowd is, the better the content comes out. And you get the way that you want the content. So with that, before I start, why are you here today? You can answer. That's my question to you. Yes, please.
I saw your, you were a panel, you were on the panel, or you were the thing in IAM.
Uh-huh.
So, and I really liked your, so when I saw this in that WhatsApp group, uh-huh. I said, no, let me go.
Okay.
And then when I said, okay, salt, what is this salt? It was something, this was something new to me.
Right.
So I said, then let me Google what it is. And then I found out a lot more about the salt world.
Okay.
And then I said, okay, fine. It's like I get two benefits when I come here to meet you also and the salt world. And I'll get to know more about this.
Great. Awesome.
So it was for me two in one.
Super. Thank you so much. You liked me last time.
Yes.
And you came. That's a big validation, as we call it, for speakers, that somebody liked you. And then they come back to listen to you again. Thank you. And who else want to share? Why are they here? Yes.
So, I mean, as a working mother, there's always, you know, a lot of things that I keep juggling.
Mm-hmm.
Work, personal life, my social life.
Mm-hmm.
And there's very little time for everything,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Work always, you know, takes priority.
Right.
So when I heard the balance for better life, I was like, why not?
Really?
I always, you know, welcome learnings. New opportunities, meeting new people, sharing my experience, learning. It's always interactive, like you said.
Awesome.
It's always, we
yes.
learn better when we interact.
Correct.
So I thought, why not?
Uh-huh.
It's an opportunity for me to, you know, probably get to know you a bit better. I
really?
Read about you.
Yes.
I said, okay, why not? Let me just, you know, go and, you know, meet like-minded people. And I live here, so I know the place.
Right.
And I was also curious to know what's happening inside.
Uh-huh.
It was a good session where it said a blend of both.
Right.
Like a good. And
awesome.
Let me just, you know.
So you already balanced it.
Thank you.
So
you
that's
have to go, you know, to continue doing this juggling lot of
uh-huh.
things. But
uh-huh.
then putting your foot down and say, no, I am going to do this, it makes a lot of difference.
Cool. Awesome. So we have two men, I see, in the room. One of them would like to speak at least. भाई तो बोले भाई को क्यों धकेल रहे हो खुद बोलो भैया
जस्ट नो यू टोल्ड अबाउट द लंग डिजीज
हां हां
सो माय लंग इज नीड इन्फेक्टेड
ओके
सो आई जस्ट वांट आई जस्ट व्हेन टोल्ड अबाउट दैट आई एम लाइक नाउ इंटरेस्टेड अबाउट दिस
हम्म हम्म ओके सो एनी पर्टिकुलर रीजन योर लंग इज इन्फेक्टेड यू कैन बी ऑनेस्ट इट्स ऑल राइट वुमेन विल नॉट जज यू
वुमेन
डोंट जज यू सॉरी
आई स्मोक अ लॉट
So have you stopped or you still smoke?
I've controlled it. Trying to reduce it.
Mm.
Not stopped till now.
Okay. Okay, cool. You can clap whenever you feel like. You know, that's all right. He was brave enough to share his story and share his fears or inhibitions, or sometimes do you feel guilty or shameful about what you do? Okay, good. That's fine. So that's about it. Now, okay. So why I chose to speak here? One was, the topic was absolutely close to my heart. As women, and sometimes, of course, as men, I wouldn't say sometimes, in fact, always. Men, unless we balance in various aspects of our lives, it becomes very challenging to go move forward. Either we miss out on one thing or the other. And what is life without having fun of everything, enjoying everything, isn't it? So that was the reason I chose to speak here. Plus, Dipti is a good friend. When she said that we wanted to do something different, I said, okay, let me go there and talk to you all. So we are going to talk about, of course, Balance for Better is the tagline of this year's International Women's Day, right? So what do you think Balance for Better means?
Yep.
Like, you know, just give me a you can shout out. What do you think balance for better means to you, especially? I need new faces to talk. See, I'm going to pull you out a lot and talk, because when you talk, when you interact, as she said, you learn better and you have aha moments. So I am going to be very, very interactive. So, questions? Or rather, say, what do you think balance for better means? Somebody wanted to know about sexual harassment. Who was that? How old are you, darling?
16.
16. You don't look 16, by the way. Look what? 12, 13 probably, isn't it? Yeah? So fine, I will talk about that as well. So what do you mean by balance for better?
Life is better when you balance both the good and the bad.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you concentrate into a lot of things, it's good.
Okay. Yes, I
it's
agree.
Nice perspective.
Yes, true. Very true. Any other?
It's like balancing between professional and personal life.
Yes, that's true. So what are the areas of your life that do we need balance? So let's move forward with the this thing. Why do we need to balance? What are the reasons that we need to balance? Do we really need to balance? Can we just concentrate doing one thing? We talk about that, you know, you become expert when you do a certain things. So then do we really need to balance in our lives? What do we think?
To be happy and content, we have to balance.
Okay.
Sense of satisfaction.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes things can get too chaotic if you just do one thing and neglect the other.
Right, true. So we know
bored
that.
Also. Come get on. Bored also doing one thing.
Whoa, I like that idea. You know, I get bored very, very often, so I do multiple things. A lot of people ask me, how do I do multiple things? I run a fashion company, by the way, and I speak, I write, I've written 3 books, I've contributed in 3 books, and I'm writing a solo book right now. I do a lot of videos. I coach people one-on-one. So I like doing multiple things, but I don't multitask. There's a difference between doing multiple things and multitasking. So yes, absolutely, all of these reasons why we need to balance. We also need to balance because you want to live a fulfilled, content, satisfied, well-funded, we call it. How many of you think that money is not important? How many of you think that money is very important? Yes. So we need to earn as well, right? While we are enjoying life, we can only enjoy life with money. I believe money is a resource, right? And unless you have that resource enough, or you know how to create that resource enough, you can't enjoy life. At the same time,
means to get what you want.
Yes. At the same time, it's also important to understand that most people, and I quote, most people work for money. Money doesn't work for them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that is something that I think all of us must look into. Financial stability versus financial literacy is very different things. You know, a lot of people have finances. For example, Vijay Mallya had so much money. Could he manage with his money? That's the difference, right? So we do need to balance because of various aspects that we need to experience in our lives. And women specifically needs to balance today because there's so much of, I call them distraction. Because you have to take care of your family, you have to take care of your, kids, you have to take care of your house, you have to take care of your work, you have to perform everywhere best. And how many of you have heard this, women are superwoman?
No.
How many of believe in that?
Particles.
You believe in that? I don't believe in that. The reason is, the moment you put a woman to a pedestal, that you are superwoman, what is happening to you?
Expectation
goes up, right? That's what is happening now, exactly.
And so when to, to meet that bar in the other person's eyes, you end up doing so many things without even acknowledging.
Correct.
Nobody is even there. Forget appreciation, that's like too much.
Correct.
You even acknowledge. And you get frustrated also.
Correct.
Why am I giving this appreciation?
Correct. So yesterday I was talking to a friend of mine. She is almost my age itself. Don't ask me my age right now.
It's
questions.
Numbers. Just like that. I'm just joking. But yeah, so she is having high BP. She's an accomplished woman in a professional field. She's in a very senior position. She has a reasonably good house. She has help in the house. She has a daughter who's very almost my daughter's age and all of that. She's going through last few days. She's going through high BP. So I just talking to her yesterday. I asked her, do you take a lot of responsibilities on your own shoulders? She said, sometimes I do. I said, where do you do that? In your work or in your house? She said, both places. I have 50 things doing in the office, which I'm going to complete. And I have 50 things to do at work. I mean, at home, I have to complete those as well. And I said, okay, how do you feel when you are able to complete and when you are unable to complete? She said, when I complete all of these, I feel tired. I feel exhausted. And when I don't complete all of these, I feel guilty. I feel upset. I feel inadequate. So what do you think is happening with her?
Both ways you are lost.
Both ways she is in a negative frequency of the space. Now if that is what is happening with you.
Every day.
Then you must figure out a way. So just telling her that, why don't you do this? Why don't you start saying no? No, so she had to say no to something day before yesterday and she was feeling guilty about it. So I was talking to her and she said that I am feeling guilty about it, that I had to say no to this. I said, I am glad that you did this. If you wouldn't have done this. So this is what we should all ask ourselves every single time we want to go jump into doing multitasking. We all like doing multitasking. I used to like doing multitasking till about 3-4 years back. And I went into a deep depression because of that. And I came out and then I realized that, the multitasking doesn't work. Though I like doing multiple things, at one time I wouldn't do more than one thing. So that is a difference, how you narrate your life, right? So I told her to do this, that every time you feel like taking a responsibility, ask yourself, what am I going to gain out of it? Right? What is that? So every time that we do anything, today that you have come here, you have let go of something and come here?
Yes. Sir.
Something you have let go and come here, right? Every single time we do something, we let go of something else. When we sleep for 8 hours, we let go of something else. When we say drink, we let go of something else. When we spend time with friends, we let go of something else. So we are always bartering. We are always balancing between should I take this versus should I take that. So all I asked her to do, and this is again a very good actionable item that you guys can use it to balance for better, whenever you want to take up something, ask yourself this question, what am I bartering this with and is it worth it? So this question, once you ask yourself, you will be able to take better decisions. And that's when your balancing will become much better. Now, what are the things that we want to balance in our life? One is work-life balance. Yeah? What else?
Our own emotional balance, self.
Absolutely, that's a brilliant point. Yes, we need to balance our emotions as well. Health. We ignore our health.
Yeah.
How many of you walk on a daily basis? How many kilometers or how many minutes?
3 kilometers.
5 to 6 kilometers. I run behind my cats. So.
That's an exercise. Sure, that's not walking.
She's one step further.
Yeah, very smart. She works with me. She knows my questions, what I ask. So she's been trying to be smart. That's why I knew I had to ask this question. So, all right. I mean, see, we are talking about work-life balance. Work is only one part of your life. How many hours do you spend in work? 8? 9? So it's like 1/3 of your day, ideally. But how many of you work for more than 10, 12 hours? Okay. So how many of you, so it's about 5 of you, right? Others are within 8 hours. You're within 8 hours. So that's 1/3 of your day. Have you ever looked into your rest of the day? What do you do the rest of the day?
Rest.
Do you really rest?
know, you're drained out, so you're just...
Do you really take 8 hours sleep, proper sleep?
Yeah, sometimes.
Mm-hmm. What about the other sometimes?
Sometimes, again, we got indulged in some work because it's not always 8 and it's not always 12.
So here is a thing that you guys can do it to find out that how much are you really spending your daily life for work. Just keep writing down through the day from the time you wake up till the end of the day, till you sleep and wake up next day. Basically 24 hours, just jot down how many hours you do what. And you know what, very interestingly, you will find out the time depleters, which depletes your time without letting you do the proper balance. Social media is one big challenge that we all face. That is like a known culprit, if I may say so. But there are others as well. There are quite a few of them. You know, I have seen people, you know, they would just look at their phone, keep scrolling social media as usual. That is one thing. Second thing is that they will randomly do certain things without having a proper understanding of what is the reason that they're doing it for and why they're doing it for. Okay. Third thing is that meeting wrong kind of friends. How many of you go to parties? Go to parties. At the end of the party, do you feel energized or do you feel depleted? Depleted. Probably you're not meeting the right kind of people. Look into it. Yeah, so that is what I call it, time depleters. So find out your time depleters and you will know that what is actually depleting your time. And once you know what is depleting your time, you will be able to better utilize it. A lot of people talk about habit change. We can't change habits. Smoking is a habit?
It used to be a habit.
Now?
Whoa,
my dad was like a chain smoker. He used to smoke 30 cigarettes a day and I used to go nuts with that. So 40 is like, naman bolte na, so I will do that to you. Now what is happening with you?
It's like around
10 or 15 max. Okay, that's a good one. So good thing is that you're able to control. The bad news is that whether you have 40 cigarettes or 10 cigarettes, it does the same effect on your lungs. That's the way. It is not like liquor. Liquor, at least if you have one peg versus four peg, there is a difference. It doesn't harm in the equal amount in your liver. Whereas for cigarette, it is the same. Whether you have one cigarette versus 40 cigarettes, it doesn't really matter. It creates the same amount of impact in your lungs. So the choice remains with you, what you want to do again on that. Now, other than your work life, as I said, health needs to be balanced. So what is health? How do you feel healthy? What is that you can do to be healthy? Or what is that?
So many things.
Lifestyle.
Eating right, food, then emotional balance,
uh-huh.
Sleeping well,
uh-huh.
Building harmony around you,
uh-huh.
Managing your anger,
uh-huh.
All these things, you know, it will take care of your health.
Correct.
And building your immunity.
Correct.
How fit are you? Multiple.
Yes. So, as I said, one is your work life. Honestly speaking, you can't balance your work and life. All you have to do is to integrate the both. How many of you believe that you should keep your work and your personal life separate? Can be honest. All of you can be honest. I wouldn't ask the kid. How many of you feel that your friends and your parents shouldn't meet? Do you feel that? So you feel that your parents and your friends shouldn't meet?
They should meet.
Yeah. So see, the idea is there was a buzzword saying that you should keep your work separate. You shouldn't bring your work home, or you shouldn't take your home back to, you know, workplace, and it creates a unnecessary rift between the both, etc., etc., etc. I am a believer of complete opposite. I believe that you need to integrate your work with your home. Unless your work and your boss and your colleagues know what's happening in your house, they wouldn't be able to see your perspective. Vice versa. unless your family knows what's happening in your work, they wouldn't know what is going on with you. And in this world, unless you give somebody a perspective, they wouldn't be in your side. To balance, you need everybody in your side. You don't want to fight with the other side. You shouldn't be in one side and the rest of them the other side. You should have everybody on your side, only then can you have a balanced, you know, workout. So I teach a longer program, which is called Connect to Success. There are three pillars in that. One is you, that's your personal self. One is your professional self. And the third is your personal friends and family self. Unless all these three are integrated with your goals, you cannot grow. So let me share a personal story with me. About 8 years back, Santosh is here. He knows me for a long, long time. And Santosh, you remember when I started the Ethnic Shack, right?
Yes.
We had met that time, isn't right. it? That was like in 2013, probably?
Yeah.
NASCOM, yes. That was 2012-13, I think, yeah. So that time when I started the organization, only I knew what I was doing. My family almost abandoned me. My parents almost abandoned me because they didn't want me to quit a posh job. I used to work in ESPN Cooking for as senior product manager. A good profile, a good salary, amazing work culture, amazing office, brilliant experience in the office and everything. All of these my parents had seen it. So when I quit the job and started my first organization, they were extremely unhappy with me. So much so that for longest period of time, they wouldn't talk to me straight. They wouldn't just, you know, converse with me straight. And I wasn't able to understand what was going on. You know, why were they being so rude with me? I'm doing what I want to do the best and all that. Then eventually I realized when I myself got coached and mentored by a lot of people. That's when they said that, did you tell them what you want to do in life? Did you tell them what are your dreams are? Did you tell them that this is where I want to see myself? Did you explain them? Did you show your what is running in your head? Nobody knows what is running in your head, do they? Unless you tell them what is running in your head. So it just hit me. And then I went back and I sat down with my parents and I started talking to them and told them this is what I want to do. So my father was in the opinion that, you know, I have been a very bad father. I wasn't able to, I couldn't do my responsibilities well. Why did you quit? I wanted to see you up there. So I sat down, I said, Daddy, you have seen me in that top. You've seen me as a senior product manager in ESPN Cooking Info, and I have done that job for 10 years. That is success, isn't it? He said, yes. Then why did you quit? Why are you going through so much of pain in life? Because, you know, you're not earning anything. That time, of course, I wasn't earning anything. You don't have a team. You're struggling so much. You're working so long. You know, you're just all the time doing so many things. Why are you even doing it? You are settled, right? I said, that's because if I want to reach where you wanted me to reach, I have reached. That is one level of success. But my success lies somewhere else, far above that. If I have to reach there, then I have to do certain things. So I gave him this example saying that if Sachin Tendulkar didn't do what he did, the 10,000 hours of practice, would he be where he is today? So when I told him this, he understood. Since then, believe me, the relationship between my parents and me has drastically changed. It has become much, much better. Just because I be being honest with them and told them this is what I want to do in life. Today they see that with pride that I do so much work. Yesterday, very interestingly, I was at home and I was just chilling in International Women's Day, and I took an afternoon nap as well. And when I woke up, mom came with a bouquet of flowers and a card. She said, looks like ye tere liye aaya hai. I was like, ye kaun bheja? You know, it's like that because I knew my husband is not going to send me that. It's not that he doesn't pamper me, but I knew he's not going to send it yesterday. I was like, ye kisne bheja hai? So then I started looking at it, and the messages also were not clearly visible. The card didn't have name, etc. Then I saw somewhere it was written from somebody. Then I realized, oh, I had coached this person 2 years back to come out of their life's challenges, and she was just appreciating me on Women's Day. So that is what you get when you work in harmony, as she rightly pointed out, with your friends and family, with your professional life, and what you want to do. Yeah? Now, how do you balance? That is something that we all wonder, right? How do I balance? How do you think should I balance? What do you do right now to balance? Let's understand that first. Anybody wants to share how do you balance your life right now? Yes, go ahead.
Yeah. Let your husband and the family know about what you want to balance your life so that they can also help you out. And it's not just helping, it is they also have to take care of household chores and everything. It's not that female is meant to do only the household work and guy has to go and earn bread and butter for the house. It's no more than that. So everything has to be like guys also have to come back to the home to do something to help some, not help, to start sharing the work. And even a woman has to go out to earn bread and butter. So it should be that way. It should not be like economical. If a kid see this, then he will go and ask father, I want money, and mother, I want love. So that is like, so once he grows up, he doesn't want love more and money more, and he leaves and go.
Yes.
So that is not the thing. You need love and affection, both the genders.
Correct. So one is that, of course. So the best way to balance, one, of course, first figure out what you want to do in your life. What is that your ambitions are? What kind of work do you see yourself doing? What is that perfect life? You have to create that picture in your mind. So I was going through in 2015 I went through a very, very bad meltdown. Okay, and I was going through deep depression, as I was telling you. So at that time, one of my friend had asked me to go and do a meditation. I never believed in meditation. Never ever believed in meditation. This is bullshit. Who does this? You know, till 2015. So I had gone down. It was in 1 hour meditation session. And in that session, I saw my purpose. I still have goosebumps when I talk about it. Because I was in a room and I was sitting and I was doing. I was just closing my eyes and I was just... So he said, just whatever comes in your mind, you keep looking at it. While looking at it, I felt as if some cold wave of air was going, you know, through my face and through my body. I wasn't allowed to open my eyes to see what it was. And after a few minutes, when I opened my eyes, I asked my fellow participants, did you feel this? They said no. And when that cold air was going, you know, just brushing through my body, I could see a picture of what my life should be. That picture is still there right in front of my eyes. I can just describe it in details, like what color, who's there, what is the mood, you know, what am I doing, what am I eating, what am I seeing, everything I can explain. But that time when I saw this and I came out of the meditation, I knew what is my life purpose was. And since then, I have stopped everything else. I've explained this to my family and I've started doing what I do today. And trust me, I've never been this happy and content with myself. If you see my girl, you had seen me when I had long hair?
Yes.
So how do you see me different now?
Much more confident and exuberant. You're very happy as a person. Yes, you radiate that. So a lot different.
Yeah. So I had in my LinkedIn profile picture, I had a picture of a long hair girl. And that picture got stolen by somebody. Basically, the posers had picked it up. So I took that picture and I posted it in LinkedIn and they reported it. One of my friend saw that. And he asked me, they call me Shri. Shri, ye picture tera 5 saal baad ka hai kya? Like, you know, after 5 years, is that how you're going to look like? Like, no, this is 5 years before. You still like this. Don't go back there. So all happens with you good when you are radiating. And when you want to radiate, you have to balance it inside you and then radiate it out to balance it with others. Today, after I go back from here, it's my parents' 41st anniversary party. I'm going to go and cook something and evening there's a party. But I'm not stressed out. Why? Because I know I've told my family that this is only till this time. After this, I will go and do this. And after this, the party is going to happen. So there's a balance in my life. It's one of the most balanced days, and this is exactly how I like my work days, where I have a balance of work, I have a balance of family time, I have balance of me time. You know, you won't believe, weekly at least twice or thrice I would watch movies or some series that excites me. No TV serials, please. Who watches this Hindi or this, you know, vernacular TV serials? At least be honest, guys, if you watch it. You watch it, right? Stop watching, please. It'll do good to you. It's just a request if you watch, because my parents also watch them, and whenever I look, I'll be like, "Ye kya ho raha hai? Like, what is going on there?" You know, it's always so negative, always so negative, and it gets into your system. So I wouldn't watch TV at all. I just take Netflix or Hotstar or Amazon Prime and watch what I like. You know, what energizes me, what excites me. So how do you balance? Coming to that, what Dipti said is very important, that your goals, your ambitions in life should be known to as many as people who can support you, or who will support you. That is your family, the friends, your close confidant, your boss, your colleagues in the workplace, and everybody else do you think can help you go forward for that. That's point number one. Point number two is that you should take care of yourself first. So there was a time, how many of you believe in self-love? Do you love yourself? Are you sure? Who is the first person in your life whom you love the most?
Myself.
Liar, I know. You're lying, I'm sure you're lying. You have kids?
Yeah.
Don't you love them?
Yeah, but no, I still don't take care of my kids.
Now, just because she said, you had to say this, no? No, but that's the honest thing, right? I mean, when somebody asked me a few days back, who do you love most? I also said my kid. And then I realized, shit, what am I doing? It's not what I should be doing. It's important that I love myself first. Only then can I radiate it outside. So start loving yourself. What can you do to love yourself? Give me a couple of things that you can do to love yourself.
Keep yourself calm, no matter what. I mean, in your own ways, how you can.
No, man, you can't keep yourself calm. I get angry very often. How can you keep yourself calm?
Control your emotions. And
okay. Do you feel good about controlling your emotions?
I mean, not all the time, but sometimes you really have to take care of yourself.
Balance life.
How do you do that? My question is, what can you do to love yourself? Yes, Santosh, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, do what you like, eat what you like,
yes.
Go, if you, whatever you like doing, you should do that more often.
Right.
What makes you happy.
Yes.
Human.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, absolutely.
And not feel guilty about it.
And not
yeah.
feel guilty
yeah,
about
that's
it.
The
that's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yes. So what do you do to feel good about yourself, what you like?
And that's to do what.
So what exactly do you do? So for example, for me, when I read books, when I listen to music, and dance endlessly, I feel amazing. I have few songs that energizes me in 20 seconds. What do you do with your life to feel that energy?
I guess all of us have our own ways.
Exactly. All I'm asking you is to bring out those ways so that people who do not know that how to do it, they know, okay, these are some of the things I can probably try.
For me, a good workout energizes me. I feel
really?
Very good when I work out.
Right.
Then my work, the actual work that I do, I don't really differentiate, but the work that I do gives me a high, and I achieve something gives me a high, because you know, every day you do something that's what will take you
right.
from a goal, right?
Right?
Setting goals, achieving them. So my goals, when I set it, they're always personal goals, professional goals, social goals, financial goals.
Brilliant.
So all the four, one by
that's
one.
A perfect way of actually keeping in balance. How often do you set your goals?
Short-term
goals. Okay, how often do you set your long-term goals?
Once, 2, 3 months.
Okay. I see people silent, and then I will also get silent. I'm looking for energy from all of you.
So the way I do it is, like, one is like, first and foremost, first I want to know what I want from my life.
Correct.
Then my bigger goals come.
Right.
To achieve that, what are the things that I need?
Correct.
Then they become smaller goals. And any goal has to be time bound. It can't be forever.
So do you want to give an example?
Example.
for example, if I, you know, I've, like when you said like personal goals, in personal goals subset is, I want to travel. If I want to travel, if it's an international trip, I know I need, you know, anywhere between 2 to 3 lakhs. I break that down and say in a year, if I have to, you know, save 3 lakhs, like let's say next year if I have to go, this year how much I have to save every month. So I put it that way, and every month I start saving. I mean, that's how I do.
Correct. So that's a right way
so
of
time,
doing
it. It has to be time.
So do you have a defined outcome of your goals?
Yes. So for example, because I'm also working, right? At work, the way I set my 1 year plan, and I go back, review, and I'm answerable to somebody when I am having a conversation against each goal, what did I achieve? Similarly, I do for all my other goals. Personal goals, how my, if it's about reading, I'll set a goal that I have to read 2 books. How am I doing? For example, reading books only will take, right? I have to read 2 books in 2 months. So 1 book per month. So if it is 1 book per month, how many pages am I reading every day? If one day it is not happening, I have to do that the next day. Otherwise, it will just not happen.
Correct. And that's a brilliant way of, I think she deserves a clap for doing it. Now, my question is, how many of you actually do something that she does?
First tip is writing. First, start writing it and reviewing it. Make those notes. There's something that I do. In a week, I do this weekly. In a week, whatever interactions that I have, really not everyday interactions, something that really stands out, good, bad, ugly, just write it out and keep. And every Saturday in the evening, I just, you know, like around half an hour, I keep it for myself. Go look at all those engagements and I introspect again. What went well, what didn't go well? The one that went well, how can I do better? So that I do the good things. This is like start, stop, continue. What is that I should start which I've not done? Stop, what I should stop which didn't make me feel good? And continue something that went well, I should continue on that behavior. These are the 3 things that I do, that engagement.
So let me put it in one single word. Awareness. Nothing else. You need to be aware of who you are, what you're doing, and how it is helping or not helping. When you create that awareness around you, you will know, okay, this is where the problem is. Majority of us are not aware where the problem is. You know, and because of that, we keep following the same pattern again and again and again and again. Right? And then we don't know we are in that loop. Have you seen that hamster which keeps going inside a wheel? Continuously going inside that wheel thinking that it's moving? But it doesn't actually move, isn't it? So most of us behave that way. And very importantly, all of you should know this, that all of us have a pattern of responding to certain things. Everything, whatever we do. How we brush, how we eat, how we dress, how we talk, how we respond to a stress situation or a happy situation. We all have that pattern. Do you know your pattern? Yes or no? Question is, do you know your pattern? That is important step. When you know your pattern, you know what are the patterns that is helping you, what are the patterns that is not helping you. And when you know that these are the patterns that is not helping me, like for example, can I get your name?
Walden. Yeah.
You're like Walden, for example, he came to know that smoking 40 cigarettes wasn't helping him. So he went to 15 right now. Yeah? So that you figured some way that it is not helping you. Correct? So you wanted to change that pattern. Unless he would have known that, probably if you would have gone to the, you had gone to check, master health checkup, that's when you found it out, right? So that is what I'm talking about. Can we do master health checkup of our emotions and our minds regularly? We don't even need to go to the doctor to do that master health checkup. It can be done by ourselves, as long as we ponder. Once in a week, once in a month, once in 3 months, whatever suits you. Sit down, ponder what is happening. So I have this ritual that I do every year end. I write yearly goals, and based on those yearly goals, I break it down to what is my action items for the daily thing. And I also teach the same thing when I coach people, that how do you write your yearly goal and then break it down to a manner that you know what I need to do today to reach there tomorrow, to reach there 365 days later, right? So I do that in my programs, all of them. So when you do that, right, you know that, okay, every action that I am taking, everything that I am doing is taking me there. And you can do that for yourself. You don't need anybody's help. Best part is that. But we don't do it. So today, can you take the pledge that I will sit down with myself once in this frequency, whatever frequency that suits you, and ponder over, thinking. Majority of the leaders, if you ask them how much they spend their times in doing versus thinking, they'll say 70% thinking, 30% doing. And what we do? Exact opposite. We're doing 30% of the time and thinking only 30% of the time. Which is why we are in that rut. So that's another way of how to balance. You know, once you know what to balance, you will know how to balance. Right? Any questions so far? Yes.
When you're setting your goal, mm-hmm. and I'm pushing her also, and yearly, mm-hmm. what is the success rate?
Sometimes 100%. I have seen success rate of, let me give you my example itself. 2017, December, mid-December, I set my goal. Generally, 31st December and 1st of January, I'm sitting with my goals. I don't go to parties. I don't go meet anybody else. I don't do anything else. I'll sit with my goals on 31st December. Taking a reflection of the last year and putting my next year's goal into the place, right? That's what I do. And so this year I was traveling that weekend. We were traveling as a family. So I knew I wouldn't have that time. So I set my goals in around 15th of December, 2018. By 31st December, two of my goals already realized.
So the reason I'm asking is I do it every year, from the last 7 years now.
Mm-hmm.
But every year when I set my goals, I do achieve 70-80%. Rest 20% still gets,
which is okay. Don't feel bad about it.
And the rest of it, takes a longer time. But eventually, when you look back 5 years, you anyways achieved it.
Correct. Now, what happens is certain goals are quickly. You can achieve it like either in a day or two's time, which is what happened to me. I achieved those goals because I put it down that I need to achieve it by this day, and I just worked on it. There are some goals which takes longer time.
They carry forward, it's similar to a more realistic setting of goals.
Yes, I was coming to that. So you got to understand, can I really finish this goal within a year's time?
But then how do we stretch ourselves? What are the goals and
so you stretch as much, it's like, have you seen the rubber bands?
Too much stretching
breaks it. Too less stretching keeps it hard. So you have to know how much is that.
Ideal
way of stretching it out. So,
in your daily lives, put down some tasks. Early in the morning, you'd have a to-do list.
Yes.
And 15 things I have to achieve.
Yes.
But on a consistent basis of last 10 years,
yes.
I'm telling you.
Mm-hmm.
Earlier when I started it, I used to do 10%.
Oh.
And I do this when I was like a kid.
Okay.
So I had a to-do list from the time I was in class 4.
Right.
And I used to only achieve 10%.
Okay.
And I was not achieving it. Then slowly came a time when I am able to achieve 80% of it, now 100% of it. So I think the goal setting also has to do with that.
Absolutely.
More of practice.
Absolutely.
More of,
so for example, if your goal is to buy a house, can you buy a house within a year's time? If you set it up today?
You can.
Depending on how. Now, of course, I don't know what are your resource choices are, right? So you need to see your resources, the resources that you will get through the year, and what is comfortably possible, what is slightly beyond comfortable, and what is really uncomfortable. Now you choose where you want to stay between completely comfortable versus completely uncomfortable. That is your playground. And even if 5%, 10% doesn't get done, which is okay, fine, you have achieved majority of it. There are so many people who don't even have goals, so therefore they don't know what they want to achieve. You're in a better place, aren't you? So that's what with the goal setting. Any other questions so far?
On the goal setting, I just want to add one thing. It's very important for us to be a little agile on our own goals. Because otherwise we're too hard on ourselves. Like the first topic that we discussed, we want to...
Can you park yourself there? Yes. So what she said is that we are always hard on ourselves. Do you agree with that? What do you tell yourself when you do something great? When you achieve something awesome, which you thought that you could never achieve?
It's like,
you keep quiet. Yeah. You don't talk. I'm asking others. I tell you what you think. I know it. I'm asking others here. Okay, so what do you tell yourself when you really achieve something? Do you really tell that to yourself? Do you pat yourself in the back? Do you treat yourself? Do you go gaga over it?
I think the problem is we can tell ourselves, okay, very good. I had never thought I can do something like this. And I'm very proud of myself that I was able to. But you don't get those affirmations from,
why do you need that affirmation from outside?
No, you do. Because you need to know that you are being appreciated in a similar manner, at least, if not up to that extent.
So here is what I say there to that is, if you underestimate yourself, who will estimate you correctly?
Correct.
So when you are not, so here is the thing. When somebody gives you a compliment, how do you respond?
Oh,
your
no.
dress is very nice.
No, this whole thing.
Thank you.
Your lipstick
you.
Looking very beautiful. Do you say thank you regularly?
Yes.
Yeah. I love your t-shirt. Let's go said to fair. Sorry?
I also didn't understand what's written.
Ha, so I was like, let's go said, not to fair, said, what's I do? Okay. So, but that's an interesting one. It just focuses somebody on you.
Yes.
So that's why it is interesting. What would you do if somebody says that to you? What would you do if somebody says, I want to gift you something?
Wow.
Hey, liars. Santosh is lying right now. I mean, shut up. Yeah. No, seriously, but when somebody gifts you, what do you say?
It's not needed.
Exactly. It's not needed. Why did you get it? What was the need for it?
So much burden
you have taken.
So
why? Somebody is gifting you, means they are appreciating you. We want somebody to say, oh, you are good. But we wouldn't accept it.
Yes.
Now, universe is very funny. Universe works exactly the way you want universe to work. If you do not receive more, universe will stop giving you. If you don't accept it with gratitude, universe will stop giving you. And it's the truth. The moment you start accepting it with, you know, so I used to be like, you know, you as you said, right? No, indeed. And if somebody would say, you're looking nice. Oh, no, it's nothing like that. If somebody would say that, oh, you talk really well. Oh, that's normal. You know, so like that. Then I realized that that wasn't helping me. I wasn't appreciating myself. And therefore, people stopped appreciating myself. They stopped appreciating me. So what was happening? Neither am I appreciating myself, nor they are appreciating me. So both are going down. The balance is not happening. Then I stop doing that. Today, if somebody says, I want to gift you, I'll say, okay, I'll accept it with thanks. And genuinely from heart, I'm saying thank you. Yesterday when the gift came, I was for some time shocked. You know, I was like, ye kya hua? You know, and then I was like, awesome. Like, that's really good. That means I've done a good job. You know, I felt really good about it. In fact, I wrote about it also. So, you know, it's that important. Before you ask others to appreciate you, you must appreciate yourself. Do whatever you like to appreciate yourself. But please appreciate yourself. That will bring balance in your life. From the time I started appreciating myself and accepting my failures, my mom stopped telling me, you can't make round rotis. Honestly. You know, honestly. So, my in-laws never questioned me whether I can make round rotis or not, but my mother did. And she stopped questioning me after I started saying that, Mama, really, mere se roti nahi hota hai. Aap parathe banwa lo, puri banwa lo, kuch bhi banwa lo, but don't ask me to make roti. So she started accepting that and she said, okay, toh se nahi, roti nahi hoti, toh chhod, mat kar. You know, and she doesn't sting and say, tumse toh round roti nahi hoti hai. So it's all about that. As long as you realize that, it will go in your favor.
I just want to add one
yes.
perspective. When it comes to, you know, accepting it, as people, I think, you know, the more, or the if you're someone who are the giver,
just giving also tires you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I totally agree. So coming back to the friend that I was talking about who's going through high BP, she's a giver. She loves giving. She just gives, 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 gives. And she wouldn't receive.
But they
it
don't
as
even
much.
Realize that they're also getting. I mean, it's
no, but she's not receiving, no.
Yeah.
She's not as open any, right? When she's receiving. She's blocking that receiving.
Receiving part, yeah.
So what is happening? The balance is getting lost. You should be a great giver at the same time great receiver.
Receiver also. Yes.
You know, so
accepted.
Acceptance is
especially
absolutely
when
important.
People come and say, hey, can I help you? Both hands.
Yes. Yes.
Take it.
Yes. So I used to be a I used to find it very difficult to seek help.
Say yes to help.
Yes. Seek help. Mujhe help chahiye. I want this help. You know. Now though I you know when Santosh I reach out to you whenever I need help, right? But initially when he met me, I knew what he did and I knew how he could help. Still I wouldn't reach out to him.
No, I guess you know this is another aspect, right? We're all we fear rejection, big deal, right? So what? Ask if it is possible, they'll say yes. There's no obligation, right? If no, move on, right?
Yes.
There's someone else who can give you.
Correct, correct. So it's important. I realized this when I went to IIM Bangalore for a course, and that's when one of the teachers said that you have this problem. Said, yeah, I don't find help. Like you have 30 other people in your class. Do you think any of them can help you with this? I said, yeah, there are 2-3 of them. Did you go and ask them? I can. I was shocked that I can ask for help, learning that. And when I came to know that I could really ask for help, I started receiving the help. Few days back, I had reached out regarding learning. How many of you are from digital space? So there is something called MailChimp, which is an emailing system, right? I was finding struggling to use that, and then I said, okay, let me reach out to my groups and say if there is anybody who can teach me that. I reached out, 10 minutes, 5 people responded saying I will help. Just 10 minutes. I wasn't even expecting that kind of help in 10 minutes. I was thinking, okay, end of the day, I'll check my messages and I'll see how many of it actually responded. That is the, you know, that's the way you can change the balance in your system. Yeah? Now, questions. Any more questions? You wanted to know about sexual harassment. What do you know about it? Let me first ask you that.
Like, sexual harassment is a major problem, not only in India, but all over the world. But there are a lot of movement where girls just stood up and they said no. But still, there is no, like, it isn't stopping. It's happening everywhere.
Okay, so what's my perspective to it, right? So yesterday I was having a discussion with the senior director of IBM, and they have these Women's Day functions and they were talking about it. So the conversation was in this structure that there are women who are really going through a challenge because of the men are, you know, only looking at their body as a body and not seeing them as a human being who can be equal as them, right? On the other hand, women are taking undue advantage of this scenario where men are being taken as a, you know, as the predator, we call it, that they are always the predator. So the idea was that, okay, women are supposed to do this and men are supposed to do this. Which is getting blurred right now. If you look at 30 years back, where you were not even born, maybe you should ask your grandparents or parents, right? They will be able to tell you how women were at that time versus today. There was a lot of difference. Like my mother, who was about 55, she was a homemaker. She was married off at the age of 17. Okay, and so my father was a bread earner and she used to take care of the family. So there was a demarcation of roles. And because there were demarcation of roles, so the chances of sexual harassment, barring the ones that is within the house, was much lesser. Now what has happened in the last 30 years is that women are being taught to go out, take care of their ambitions, work on their ambitions, work, etc., etc. Whereas, unfortunately, we forgot about the men that they also need to be taught to cope with that. Do you have a brother? Do you have friends who are boys? Do they behave differently?
Actually, I don't talk much.
Okay.
They don't actually know the girls.
Okay, and why do you think that happens?
I have a cousin.
You have a cousin?
Yeah.
Does he behave differently versus you?
No, actually.
He knows to cook? Do you know to cook?
Yeah.
Why he doesn't know to cook?
He's not interested.
Okay, who decided that?
I guess the family.
That's what happens. So what happens is that when we are bringing up boys and girls, we are bringing them as boys and girls. We are not bringing them up like human beings. Because of which the balance is broken, and that's why you have all these situations. So yesterday the discussion was around, can we bring up kids as gender agnostic? Can we really bring them up as gender agnostic? In the sense, they don't look at the other person as she's a girl, or he's a boy. Rather, they look at each other as another human being. When that happens, automatically the changes will happen. Okay, what is sexual harassment? Sexual harassment is nothing but when a person, you know, barges into other's personal territory without their approval. That is what is sexual harassment, if I have to put it in your language, which will make you understand. Now, in India, I find it very difficult. People don't know the physical space. Now, I'm standing here. There's a physical space around me which I don't want anybody to enter into. And I find that happening. Have you stood in queues?
Yeah.
You see people banging from behind?
Yeah.
Yeah, or front, they just come behind. You know, you have to keep one hand like this and one hand like this to be able to stop people from banging onto you. So that is what not being taught in the society, that there is a personal space and you need to be away from that personal space. Secondly, there is a lot of something called toxic masculinity. What it is, if I show my power on the weaker race or who I think is weak, that means I'm stronger. That's a bullshit way of thinking. And I'm being absolutely honest about it. Okay. Recently, I was in I had gone for a conference in Chennai, and last minute also I didn't know that I would be going for that conference. So I knew the conference, the guy who was leading the conference, I called him, listen, I have not booked my place, what do you want me to do? So he said that you can stay, we have arranged a stay for all of the people who are coming from various parts of the country, so we put a place there and you can stay with them. So I asked them, is it a gender agnostic place? He said yes. Even then I was afraid, still I went. Once I went there and I went into the hotel room or wherever, the room there where we were staying, there were five men and I was the only woman in that entire room. Okay, when my husband came to know, he was obviously, you know, afraid that, okay, how are you going to stay with strange men whom you don't know, first time you're meeting them, and how are you going to stay with them through the night, or what are you going to do? Why don't you go stay in a hotel? It'll be safer. Honestly, I thought about it. I said, if I don't take this step today to stay with them and find out whether I feel unsafe, which I have of course found it earlier, I will never know whether the world has changed or not. And honestly speaking, I have never felt this safe
very
in
good.
My entire life. You know, seriously, like it was
one
so amazing.
Matters a lot.
It was so amazing, that experience. So of course I had to send their phone numbers to my husband. I kept my phone on just in case something wrong happens.
No, we continue to take precautions.
Yes.
But, you know,
yes.
Continue taking these steps with precautions.
Yes. So I took that step, and when I realized that this is something that is extraordinary, next day when I saw these five folks together in the same room, I sat down and I thanked them.
In fact, they are also learning.
They
also know how to treat a woman.
Yes, yes. So, because I did that, because I stayed with them, next day I thanked them. They were like, yeah, I would never allow my wife to stay with five men like this. I would never, you know, have my sister going. Now I will. Now I know that, you know, it's not necessary that all men are bad. All men are bad, right? It's not necessary that. It's just that how we see that world and how are we able to take care of it. Having said that, there are also men who take advantage of just being you being a woman, which also happens. Now, as women, we just need to know smartly to push them off from our system. That's about it. It doesn't have to be all the time men are bad, women is good. Men are bad, men are dirty, men are this, women are this. I don't trust, I'm
no
not,
labels,
I don't believe
please.
In that. No labels, please. Zero labels, you know. Another thing, we talk about empowerment. We talk about women empowerment or not. Honestly speaking, I don't think women need empowerment. They don't need empowerment. They know what they need to do in life. They can take their choices. As long as they are left alone and let them take their own choices without having to ask somebody or without having to, you know, seek permission. The moment you seek permission, what are you doing?
Submitting yourself to someone.
Which means you are lower and somebody is higher position.
Higher.
You take permission from whom? Principals? Bosses? Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah, I'm not seeking for an approval.
Why would you do that? You just
there.
Not
permission,
sure.
Rather permission.
Yeah, and it becomes like a permission. It's. I have seen so many men saying that I allow my wife to work. But who are you to allow her? So,
and they
what
think,
do you mean?
And they think it's
a big deal they're doing. That's again a toxic way of thinking.
The way I look at it is the women are allowing that to happen too.
I agree. I totally agree.
But yeah, they do it.
Yes,
you know?
I agree.
Like just yesterday, I was talking to one of my team member who's saying, I have to give my money to my husband. It's like, I mean, are you okay with it? Which is okay, right? We all support. It's a one family, right? Family fund. So are you okay with that? Not really. He doesn't give. Then there's a problem.
Yeah. So then there of course is a problem, right? So
and who will fix it? That woman.
Yeah.
Nobody else.
Yeah. So all you have to do is keep yourself safe without having to doubt every single person that you meet. My daughter is 10 years old. At the age of 6, she said, I don't want to wear checks. Why? Boys wear checks, it seems. You know what I did? I went to the shop, bought some 3-4 check shirts, started wearing them. So, you know, the moment I started wearing them, she said, Mama, checks look nice. I said, yeah, you can wear it too. Then she also started wearing them. So it's all about how do you
educate,
yes.
You know, and never, you know, make that statement,
yes.
Oh, you're a girl, do this.
Yes.
Oh, why are you behaving like a
boy?
Boy,
yeah.
Boy,
yeah. Oh, God,
yes.
I hate those sentences. You know, have you guys been to buy toys or buy gifts
yeah.
for birthdays?
Yeah.
What is the first thing they ask?
I went to buy a towel. Okay, and he said it's not there for
girls.
I was like, what makes a towel is a towel for a guy? Or no, it is in blue color. It is to wrap. It is wrap the body. It is to wrap the body. Nothing else. Please give that saddle cloth only, which is blue.
So I do this
all
every
marketing.
Single time.
Strategy.
Yeah, those are our marketing strategy, and what it does doing is it's dividing.
It's dividing.
It's dividing it even further. Instead of bringing it closer, it's dividing.
In fact, nowadays, I mean, it's good. A lot of people are demystifying that thought and say, I'm going to buy clothes which are gender neutral.
Exactly.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
We don't care.
This is what I do whenever I go to a toy shop for a gift for somebody.
Look
at
you, you're wearing blue.
I love wearing blues. I just love wearing blues. So I will say, okay, they'll say, okay,
it
for a boy.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah. And I'll say, how does it matter? No, boys means we'll give this. Girls means we'll give that. I said, okay. How do you know the girl that I'm buying for doesn't like that? You know, so I'll have a conversation. Yeah, and I'm like, it is important for him to know that he doesn't have to ask this question. Let me be. You just say which age group and let me sort it out what I want. So that's how that can be taken care of. All you have to do at your age to know that there is a personal boundary that you have, personal space that you have, and if you are not okay with it, do not allow others to enter that space. That's all. Whether it's a girl or a boy, doesn't matter. As long as you keep that space for yourself, that's all right. Yeah? So, any other question around that? Sure? You got your questions cleared? Okay. All right. So, yeah. Forget it. So, it's okay. Not required. Leave it. So we talked about the how of it, right? Now, can you imagine a life where you are already balanced in the areas of life where you want balance to be there? How would your life be? Maybe you can take a minute to close down, close your eyes, and think of that life. Are you ready? You can relax, sit relaxed, and close your eyes. Just in your head, think that every aspect of your life is in balance. You're in total harmony. You're able to take decision comfortably without any challenges, without any roadblocks, and you have the best relationship with your close ones, and you have a very, very understanding relationship with your boss, with your colleagues, with your friends, and everyone who is important in your life, and they know what balance means to you. What are your ambitions? What you want to do in life. They know that. And they acknowledge it. And they support you in everything that you want to do. Not if you are already seeing the light, you're able to picturize. Are you able to see your life? On. Stay there. Put yourself on the center of that light. Start radiating your aura. See that white light is going around, touching each and every sphere of your life. You're happy, you're content, you are radiating the white light through your spine, through your actions, through your stay there, enjoy it, experience each bit of it. Bring that in your heart. Take that light and imprint it in your heart. Once you're done imprinting in your heart, place your hand in your heart. Once you're done imprinting in your heart, place your hand on your heart. Your eyes closed. Once you're done, keep your hand on your heart. Once you've imprinted that light, keep your hand on your heart. Feel it. Feel the energy. Feel the happiness. Feel the peace. Once you've felt it, bring both of your hands together. Rub it. Open your eyes. And open your eyes when you're ready. How does it feel? Are you able to see your life? Yes or no?
Yes.
Bit. I'll sit with you separately. So, just keep that face, keep that picture in your heart and work towards you. Get the balance for better life. Done? Any questions? Any last comments?
Thank you.
I have a question.
Yes, please.
I wanted to ask how, as students, how do we concentrate and effectively study?
How do you concentrate and effectively study? See, there are ways to concentrate. There are certain things different. So some people concentrate by listening to music. Some people concentrate by doing certain things depending on, okay. So it also is not only, okay, when you say you want to concentrate for how long?
Like 2 hours.
Mm-hmm. Currently, how long do you concentrate for?
After 45 minutes max. At max, I get distracted.
Okay. So after 45 minutes, you get distracted. And distracted for how long?
15-20.
That's okay. So here is what I do. When I have to, I write. I was telling, I think you guys came a little late, right? So I write. So when I write, for example, I write for 2 hours at a stretch. So two things that I do. One, I put my phone into silent mode, turn it upside down, and remove all the social media sites from the laptop. I write it on my laptop. Emails, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, everything is away. Right? For 2 hours, only I'm writing. And in my ears, I'm listening to the music that energizes me. That's what I'm doing. So for 2 hours I do that. Then once I'm done with it, then I take half an hour break. Then again I use for another 1 hour. Then I take 15 minutes break. So that's how I kind of put my concentration in place. You don't have to like be concentrated for like 3 hours at a stretch. You can do 1 hour at a time. Take 15 minutes break. Make sure you that break is only 15 minutes. Huh? Generally if that break becomes 1 hour.
That's also an issue. How
yes.
do you make sure?
So put alarm in your phone. You can put alarm in your phone that 15 minutes ke baad mujhe aur kuch karna hai. And there's a little bit of a self-control or self-regulation that is required there. You know, so it's called, I think, Pomodoro. Are you aware of that? So look it up. I think the term is called Pomodoro. How you break your concentration, again concentrate, break your concentration, and again concentrate. You know, and for study, see, I have been a person who has been studying smart. I had friends who would study for 18 hours a day, and I was maximum studying 8 hours a day throughout the day, throughout 24 hours. So that's how I have always been. So concentration ke liye, you don't need to concentrate for longer period of time. You can still finish your 5 hours of job in 2 hours if you are removing all the distraction at that time. So music really helps me because the outside noise gets cut. Whether somebody is screaming, yelling, you know, fighting with each other, talking to each other, doesn't really matter to me. In fact, I work from home, so and there are so many people running around. I have a dog in the house as well. So she's barking sometimes, she's doing something or the other. My parents are talking, there are kids in the house, they're doing that. If I have to still do something in that time, one thing that I'll do is I'll put music in my ears. Second thing I'll tell them is do not call me. You do whatever you want to do, just do not call me. That's it. So you can try that. Do you live in hostel? Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. So put something in your ear that will cut your outside noise and let you concentrate on your studies. And tell your friends not to bother you till you finish that. Any other question?
I think that timing of concentration, that actually experiment with it and then it works better, because I tried a lot of combinations, then later I realized for me 30 minutes concentration, 10 minutes break works well, and I've been
so we all have that threshold of how long can we concentrate at a stretch, and there's nothing right or wrong there. She's absolutely right. Like there are people who can do the same thing for 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours at a stretch, and there are people who can't do it for 10 minutes or more, and both are okay as long as you do that, you know, absolutely with integration and absolutely with a lot of, you know, sincerity at that time. for that period of time, for that half an hour or 30 minutes or whatever, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, whatever you're doing. And then go back, take a break. I was watching a TED video. It's called, sorry, I forget the name. I'll share the name. If they have their email ID, you can send the video to them. So this guy is, he finds very difficult to concentrate, okay, on anything for longest period of time. But his all his goals are obnoxious goals. I want to say, I want to climb all the seven summits. That's a big goal. I want to learn to, you know, fly aeroplane or fly a helicopter. I want to hold a Guinness record for this, that, etc. He has even a goal where he sew or he knitted biggest size of granny square. Like the biggest size of granny square, and he took some 3-4 months to do it. Apparently the Guinness book guys said, we don't have any category for it, I can't give you this, etc, etc. So he kept on writing to them, and then finally they said, okay, we'll create a category if you can make this big granny square. Okay. And he kept on doing it, kept on doing it. This guy can't concentrate more than 10 minutes, mind it. Still he did it, and he won that. So you should watch that video, it's amazingly hilarious. And he says anything is possible. You know, once you know your pattern and how you work, it doesn't have to be, you don't have to follow in somebody else's pattern. If your friend, say for example, can concentrate for 2 hours, 3 hours at a time, but you can't concentrate beyond 30 minutes, that's all right. As long as you take a break and then come back to it after some time, that's okay.
One more thing I think, you know, which actually really helped me was when I heard this one, I think it was from a TED talk only, where they said that, you know, we kind of try to multitask rest of the day and then we want to concentrate on one thing for 1 hour. You have trained your mind to multitask for, you know, 23 hours. How is it going to concentrate on one
thing
for 1 hour?
That's the same problem used to happen with me because I was a multitasker. I would do 5-6 things at a time. कर लिया आधा मेल लिख लिया आधा मैसेज कर लिया आधा बुक लिख लिया आधा बुक पढ़ लिया आधा कुकिंग कर लिया आधा ये कर लिया आधा वो कर लिया सो दैट नथिंग वाज वर्किंग आउट लाइक आफ्टर 2 आवर्स आई विल से यार एवरीथिंग इज आधा व्हाट इज रॉन्ग हियर राइट सो देन आई स्टार्टेड चेंजिंग माय ब्रेन्स पैटर्न एंड आई सेड एट अ टाइम आई विल डू ओनली वन थिंग मे बी आई विल डू मल्टीपल थिंग्स इन द यू नो थ्रू द डे लाइक टुडे आई एम डूइंग इट बट व्हाइल आई एम डूइंग दिस आई एम नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग एल्स आई एम नॉट इवन थिंकिंग अबाउट इट दैट आई नीड टू डू दिस और आई नीड टू डू दैट सो आई एम 100% प्रेजेंट हियर. So everything that you do at one time, just be present for that. Be present for that particular activity for that period of time. Now, once I'm done with this, I'll go out, I'll do something else. Then I will not be thinking about this role. Right? So that's how you train your mind to be more productive, more effective, and more optimist, you know, optimized version of yourself.
I also used to face a similar issue, and I had this problem of daydreaming during my teenage.
Oh, I still daydream. Yeah, what do you mean, I'm still young.
I could not study because I used to daydream for hours and hours. I used to open my book and just daydream, not study.
Yeah.
And that's a major problem. I read it in one of the newspapers. Those days we didn't have Google and all, so I read in one of the newspapers that the best way of dealing with your mind wandering away is to slot time for thinking. Like that one is slotting time. So what I used to do is, let's say I was learning something for history.
Oh, I love history.
I just hated history.
I used to read it like as if I'm reading some stories of rajas and
literature. Other than that, I just hated everything. So I used to slot time. So what time was reading? 20 minutes thinking. Think whatever you want at that time. Then read it, then thinking. That's how I overcame it over a period of time. And it increased.
That's the right way of doing it.
The concentration exercises which I did in those days, you have those circles, right? Those that you concentrate on, and you look at the candle tip and concentrate. Those things really helped me, those 10 minutes. 20. I was able to overcome it over a period of 1-2 years. So maybe you can try it out.
Find your pattern first, and then based on that pattern, you put yourself.
Mom, more than concentrating, it's about that I start losing interest in that thing after a certain period of time.
So is it because the subject seems boring to you?
No, like if I study it for 45 minutes, I feel that I am not able to give that much of my energy to the subject on that same day. maybe the next day I'll study it, but not on the same day.
That's all right. Why Wu says that you have to finish it that day?
Yeah,
seriously.
Two different things.
Correct.
Different
you
subjects.
Do something that time till how you have that interest in it. The moment you are losing, you can see that dip in the interest, right? You can't go again. The moment you feel that, keep it. Go do something else that that energizes you or that excites you or something. Come back to it when you feel like coming back. I mean, that can't be like 3 months later. that happens sometimes. But so make sure that in a day, you look into a mix of exciting things, mix of boring things, mix of things that you have to do it, mix of things that you want to do it are there. Then you will be all the time, you know, energized.
I'd like to add for that.
Yes, please.
Usually I set up a strategy. This is a simple task for me. This is a difficult one. This is easy. Just like this, I can finish off. If I pick a task only which I can finish off quickly, that by the end of the day, I'll only be doing simple tasks. So I somewhere felt all the difficult ones are just getting parked and finally I have bigger thing to clear. So I came up like, okay, I will take up the difficult one first. And then anyway, easy ones I can finish.
Yes.
So the moment you pick the difficult one first, after you clear that, you were talking about how you feel if somebody is telling that you have achieved this. So I pat my back when I complete the difficult things. And then I pick up all other smaller tasks.
In school and colleges, they teach this, right? That you attempt the difficult question first and then attempt the lighter questions. There were people like us who would tack, 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 finish the lighter questions and then take time and wonder what is the you know, so then you realize, no, this is not working out and you lose out majority of the marks there. So you first attempt the tough question. Once you're done with the tough question, then you
While studying, the first thing is you should, whichever subject you hate, first you should finish that. That's my strategy.
So that works. That what she says is that it works. It works because once you're done with that thing that you call as difficult, you're like, yes, if I can do this, this is easy, man. I can do it just like that. Like that. Yes.
I used to make like a sandwich. Like the subjects which I like, I'll keep them on two sides and the one which I don't like in the middle.
So you have so many options now.
Yeah.
And all work. Either way, all work. So you can try whichever is it. Like if one is not working, you take the action number two. Or action number three or action number four. So
and it gives you a motivation. Okay, I did something which I felt good about. Okay, let me tackle this one. And okay, let me concentrate a little more. It only 10 minutes more. After that I'll get to do something I like.
So there you go. So that's what. Any other questions? Any last comments? Otherwise we close. No? Cool. Thank you. You have been a real good audience. I love the energy, I love the way we interacted, and I enjoyed my sessions. So, okay, so I wanted to share my email ID with them. If you can switch this on, that'll be good.
So I want to thank each one of you for coming to the session and being part of this International Women's Day program, Balance for Better. So if you can also, I think you'll be available there for some time.
I can be there for 10-15 minutes.
Yes,
if you want to talk to me.
You want to talk personally or some personal issue you want to, you can.
Yeah, so I don't think the TV is on.
So we also have a free therapy session now after this. So you can stay back and experience our therapy. And if anyone wants to take a package or want to take a few sessions, can contact Dipti or me, and there will be a special offer for today, so you can definitely contact us. So especially you have some lung problem, that's very good for you, so just talk to
her. So anybody wants to take this down, you can take it down. In case you have any more queries or you want to get in touch with me one-on-one for some reason or the other, you can reach out to me. That's my office number and these are my email IDs, and you know, just stay in touch. And let me know in case I'm of any help to you guys anyway.
Sure, a small gift from us.
Oh, thank you. I love gifts, you know.
So,
thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So, there's Epsom salt in it.
Aha.
And then, short glass.
Short. July did some it.
But you have to maintain the balance.
Yeah! You know, drinking nice wines are good for him.
So you can also like our Facebook page and follow us on Instagram. We have many more events coming up every month. So you can definitely get in touch. Keep yourself updated on our programs. Thank you.